treasure of historical facts, moments, characters, narratives, and landscapes of a time that was iconic in our history. Jankidevi stands tall amongst so many brilliant men and women whose names have gone down in golden letters in the annals of human history for her simplicity, sacrifice, and service. The original text is written in a colloquial style with many Marwari references. Complicated to translate these nuances, Ms. Sudeepta Vyas has done a marvelous job of presenting the English version. There is almost a folktale-like charm about the book, and the English translation has captured this superbly. Sudeepta Vyas ji is a writer, a media industry professional, and has worked at Grey International Mumbai. She co-founded Prayas, an Indian theatre group in Auckland, New Zealand. It specializes in Indian-themed work in English in order to give a wider audience a taste of Indian culture. She works for one of New Zealand's biggest charities dealing in blindness. Her past works include editing State of Violence, a book about the Fiji coup, a translated work in Hindi poetry and a biography. She's passionate about adapting Indian language books into English and lives in Auckland. I welcome you, Sudeepta ji. May I invite you to come to the podium and say a few words. Thank you.
Thank you, IMC Ladies Day, for inviting me. To all the distinguished guests on the stage, to everyone who's here, and especially my friends and family who have taken the trouble to come here all the way. One of my friends, I think it's got something to do with Milan Soman, but don't quote me. Although I wrote this book over the last year, the idea took shape in someone's head 25 years ago, and you all know her name. She was then my boss and now my friend, Kiran Bajaj. She felt that the book would ring true at any time and there should be an English translation so that the younger generations and posterity could benefit from it. There are so many lessons to learn from Jankidevi's life, you know. Today, we have created this really superficial world where we measure success by wealth and maybe popularity, by the number of likes and comments and how many people read our WhatsApp messages and respond back. Imagine against all this backdrop, there's this woman at the age of 27 gives up every single piece of silk, all her ornaments, and says, "I'm going to serve my country." And she actually leads a very good work-life balance. She looks after her family and she looks after her country. What an amazing woman. And today we talk about work-life balance. So, she did it just with hard work, grit, and commitment. But the most important thing was her devotion to the land that she walked on. This book is really delightful. I would request all of you to read a few pages. If you can't read the entire book at a time, it will still make a lot of sense. I want to thank Kiranji, who's not here, for having her faith in me to translate this book and bring out its essence. Mukul Upadhyay. Mukulji, those long chats with you 25 years ago have helped, and you have been an encyclopedia of information about Jankidevi Bajaj. Thanks to the team at JICO for being generous with the time differences between New Zealand and India and maintaining those timelines. And finally, I would like to thank one man who always works behind the scenes. You never get to hear his name, but he has ensured that this whole machinery runs well and this book gets published on time, and that's Shekhar Bajaj. Thank you so much.